Well, here we are at the part of the Coach's Corner. You know, it's not easy doing Coach's Corner. Not everybody can do it, I'll tell you. Okay, let's roll them.
The Los Angeles Kings, I know you like this hockey team.
No, I don't like the hockey team. They got a guy, Kristich, who's their leading
scorer. That's Kristich.
Whatever it is, shut up. I'm talking about Kristich is their leading scorer. If you got to hit these guys, you'll beat Los Angeles. Toronto, I don't know what's going on in Toronto. They got some problems there, but LA won in Toronto. But I'll tell you something, Ottawa comes out hitting and elbowing. You'll see the Europeans will be gone.
Hey, that was Jim Ralph doing me, good-looking guy, and Greg Millen doing what's-his-name. I gotta admit, he does me better than me.
Yes, I think I look exceptionally good tonight.
A little reminder to turn our clocks back.
What do you mean by that?
You'll be in style. Anyway, you look good. You got a newspaper here from Hamilton.
Excuse me. Yeah.
I don't have much time. Anyhow,
lots of time.
All right, here, and at the end, you tell me to hurry. Anyhow, what happened was, you're saying it already. Now listen, if you ask me the question, let me answer it.
Yes, please.
All right,
now listen. You think you look good tonight, do you?
Exceptional.
Well, where's your poppy?
Right there, what do you mean?
Oh, it's there, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Oh, you thought I didn't have a poppy on,
I thought I couldn't recognize.
Oh, you thought you were gonna get me. You never told me to have my poppy on. You thought I lost it.
No.
Never always have my poppy on like you people should have your poppy. That's why you're sitting in your living room in the bars having a pint on account of guys that did that. Tony Schneider. Now, we got time. I got to tell you a story. This is a pretty good story. Punch Imlach had come from the Quebec League, and he was coaching a general manager of Springfield Indians, believe it or not. So I was playing on the team, and Tony was a tough guy, and I was a tough guy. And to hurry this up, we got into it in the practice. We know we're going. A Punch just let it go. And they were standing around watching us go. You couldn't believe it. We're hoping somebody builds it up, breaks it up. So anyhow, it's over. And folks, if you've ever been in a fight, your hands just shake like that. You're so tired. And the guys that fight, you know. So I put on my gloves, and I put on my other gloves, and somebody gave me the stick, and I'm standing at the blue line. If somebody passes me a puck, I'm so weak, it knocks the stick out. Tony's stepping over the boards, and he feels like this, and he feels he's cut. He goes, nah, and he comes running at me. Believe me, folks, fear will give you strength again. I got to ask you a question.
Good.
I am sick and tired of what's going on in hockey. First of all, we have the 72nd timeout. Now we don't have the tag-up rule. Now you got to call the offside. What in the world was the replay about that? We are sitting on pins and needles waiting for some guy up on TV that probably never played the game is going to tell us if the game is good. That guy's on TV more than me.
How many times were you knocked out?
I was knocked out about 10 times.
Rose says that explains everything.
Well, is that right? Rose said that?
Yes, she did.
Gotta get back
there. She's a knockout. Don Cherry in the Coach's Corner and Molson Hockey Night in Canada.
Once.
On the CBC, yes, I did. And I was mincemeat for it.
Very good advice. I know you were going to mention Brett Hull's old buddy, Oates.
Just as well, you had food poisoning. You don't want to be dealing with that. Well, you did have a baker involved. Don Cherry, Happy New Year in the Coach's Corner on... Happy New Year, I said.
So what? Keep going. You're doing all right. Keep going.
Molson Hockey Night in Canada.
Are you telling me happy?
Yes.
Now, Doug, Arva, and Elsie are still in Parry Sound.
Still in Parry Sound. We were up there last night.
Elsie, I'm the favorite with Elsie.
Grandma loves you. Yes. She thinks you're the only one that tells the truth.
Well, that's true. Everybody else loves me, too. Now, we have another goal. I had a lot of questions, but I know you want to see some nice goals. Watch this goal right here. If you don't say this is one of the best assists you'll ever see, go ahead, Mark, run this here one now. Watch this, Bobby. Do you remember this? I'm going to talk over this one. Now watch, he's got him down. I didn't know. Now watch his elbow. Watch what he does with the elbow here. I think it's Johnny Busick over there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Johnny in front of him.
Watch John. I think it's John going over there. Puts in one of his 500. Not bad, Bobby. Now, let's get last. I had Muller. This is why I've been hurt.
And the week before.
Now, you kids out there, I know you can't do this, but look at the heart of this here guy. First of all, we're going to show you. I want to show the hit again with the puck. What was Dougie shooting? Go ahead, Mark. Roll it right now. Show it right now, the hit and everything like this. Now, there he is. Cut there. He come back. By the way, Dr. Douglas. Now, here's the shot comes out. I don't know what Gilmore was shooting at. He puts it out here. He comes and watches. Dr. Douglas... put in 25 stitches in 4 minutes, a record. He comes back, there it is again. Now, if you're ever going to bail, the score is 3-0, the crowd is booing. Let's say, I can't see out of my eye. That's what most guys would say. Let me see, and Dr. Douglas put it in. Here's what he does when he comes back. He's still in there banging and smashing. He gets caught, watch coming back. He's got 25 stitches, blood running down his eye.
You ever cut this bed?
Oh, was like, I had 17 stitches in the eye one time, looked like I had three eyes. Anytime he comes back, he tries to do it, and now watch him on the bench. Hey, Nevin said he worked with him last night. Look, is that a warrior? He'd take the bullet for you. Nevin said, I worked on his line. I got three assists, because if you don't, Kirk's all over you. A warrior and a hockey player. What? We're coming back
now.
No,
you got it. It's,
we're coming here. And we got
consensual.
Something. This is consent. You were talking about consensual.
Last week.
Watch this coming up with Palfy and Green. I'm telling you, folks, it's lovers, I tell you. Watch this here now. Right on the lips. It's coming up pretty soon. Watch this. Watch it now. What's the next one coming
here
up?
Here it comes. Travis Green.
Here it is, Travis Green. It's coming over. Now, here's another reason not to wear the visor. Do you lean to the left or lean to the right? Now, I know guys with visors are sweeties, but
maybe look better after. Maybe look better after a glass.
Pardon?
Maybe look better after a glass, because, you know.
Oh.
Don Cherry. Tongue-tied on this installment of the Coach's Corner, like Ziggy Palfy and Travis Green on Molson Hockey Night in Canada. On CBC.
Beautiful. Mm.
You know, just one other thing. The Sporting News, big publication here, had a story on Paul Laws of Florida.
Hey, no.
Great fighter. They said the other tough guys are Probert, Kasparaitis, and Ulf Samuels.
Make you cry, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, these guys are supposed to be hockey guys. Kasparaitis and Samuels, fighters. Two turtle Russians. Anyhow, hey, now, you know, when the kids over, you know, we are so good. The women win. The women won theirs.
The
we
Nations
won the
Cup,
Spangler Cup. Under 17, Ontario beats Sweden 7-2 or 6-2 or something like that. We're so good. Now, while the kids are over there, we never show, you know, they get back and everybody forgets it. You know, and I said, I wonder what the headlines will be in our national paper or our paper here. Now, look at in the national paper here. Look at the headlines. Can you roll that little headline that we got here?
Don't read too much into Canada's junior hockey victory.
You know, this here... These people, how everybody thinks we have an inferiority complex, it's guys like this putting it in. We are the absolute topper. Nobody can talk. I was listening to a talk show 2 days ago saying how better the program, I know we got to get going, how much better the program is in Sweden. They won one game there, won one game in the World Tour. We are the best kids. Listen to me. I'm a hockey guy. And as we go out, I hope you've all got the VCRs going, because this is Canada. I'm not going to say another word. This is Canada. Remember this.
Got cranked by Ulf Samuelsson in last night's OT loss to the Rangers. We saw it earlier on the telecast, but you got right up. Are you a little bit stronger than some people give you credit for?
Well, Mr. Chew is going to be happy. Maybe I will do the highlight on his video. Maybe I will do the front page or something. But I know
that's stuff. Rock and docking quality, I think.
Exactly.
It sure was, Alexander. And here are some more Rock'em Sock'em Crunchers.
Oh.
And Gardner says, I'm not going to take that. Simpson put out Forsberg a long time with this one. And good guy Jones jumps in to help like he always does. Ottawa and Buffalo were sure hitting a hurt in last year's playoffs. Wait a minute, you kids, when a guy's got a hat trick and you got an open net, watch the Boston boy. I love him. He used to watch my Bruins play, Keith Tkachuk. Watch what he does to get Gartner his hat trick. Now watch it. Comes out. Now watch him look. He's looking for him. Intercepts the puck. Now watch him meander, as they say. Where is he? Where is he? Where's Mike? Come on, Mike. And Mike says, I didn't know what he was doing. That's the way to do it, kids. When you got a hat trick and you see a guy coming down, wait till that guy and give him for the hat trick. That's a good Canadian way. And I has Keith, and he is a Canadian. Hey, folks, let's listen to the sounds of hockey. Nice pass to Sanderson by Rice. Tick. Tack. Toe. Yes! Here's Amani with a few. Love his hair. Watch Cousineau catch the Rangers on a bad line change. Ooh, coaches hate that.